What's going on, everyone? Austin John Plays here, and today I'm going to be going over how you could get the mythical Pokemon Mew and the mythical Pokemon Jirachi at the very beginning of Pokemon Brilliant Diamond and Shining Pearl. Very early in your Sinnoh adventure, after you get your first gym badge at Orberg City, return back to Jubilife City and start heading north across Route 204, you're going to be reaching Floraroma Town. This beautiful little town right here has flowers everywhere, and see these two people right here? Well, they're going to be the people who are going to gift you two mythical Pokemon. Gentlemen over here on the left, oh, you there, and I gather you've seen a wishing piece before. Would you mind taking this Pokemon? I think it would be perfect for you. You obtained Jirachi. So this guy is only going to be giving you Jirachi if you have saved data of Pokemon Sword or Shield on your Nintendo Switch. And this lady over here, hi lady, why hello there. It looks like you played Let's Go in Kanto before. Would you like to go on an adventure in Sinnoh with this Pokemon? You obtain Mew. That's fantastic. And this Pokemon you're going to receive if you have saved data on your Nintendo Switch of Pokemon Let's Go Pikachu or Let's Go Eevee. The save data is not exactly the title data, so even though this is my OLED Switch and I've transferred some of the games over, I haven't transferred over Let's Go Pikachu or Eevee yet. However, the save data exists on the system. So because of that, boom, you get Mew. Do I want to give Mew a nickname? No. So this is pretty awesome. Jirachi right here is going to be registered as a question mark Pokedex number until you unlock the National Dex. It's level 5, has Serene Grace, it starts with Confusion and Wish. Mew, on the other hand, is level 1. You are going to be the original trainer, which is really fantastic. It has Synchronized as its ability. It starts with Pound and Reflect type. Previously, you were able to get Mew in Pokemon Sword and Shield, which require you to purchase the Pokeball Plus. However, that isn't the thing anymore. Now just have saved data of the previous games. And even if you bought the games, played them, and then sold the games, traded them in, or gave them to a friend or something else, if the save data is on your system, these will still work. If you've never played Let's Go Pikachu or Eevee, or Pokemon Sword or Shield, there's a chance that you might be able to go to a video game store or GameStop or a local shop and say, hey, for this, I have to just put this in, start it up, and then it creates save data, and then I get this Pokemon. Would you be okay with that? If they're not okay with it, then just buy it, do exactly that, and then trade it back into them. It might cost you, what, 5-10 bucks? Which is a heck of a lot cheaper than what the Pokeball Plus costed, that's for sure. But the fact that you're going to start with these two mythical Pokemon, you're the OT, so they're always going to obey you. Mew is absolutely fantastic. It's a full 600 stat Pokemon. I played through Sword and Shield with mine, and it became just my always go-to Pokemon. In addition, Mew is really fantastic because it can learn False Swipe, Swords Dance, and Thunder Wave. So therefore you could use it as your Pokemon in order to false swipe and catch other Pokemon, which is going to be helpful throughout the game, especially a lot of the legendary Pokemon in the post game are psychic type, so you're going to be resisting some of their attacks as well, which is pretty nice. I also just want to say that we now know the level up move set of all of the Pokemon in the game, even if it may not be updated on official websites. Mew learns a whole bunch of moves, and it seems like its move set was actually changed to be more like you're gonna have it along your adventure as opposed to previously what it was, which is level 10, 20, 30, 40, so on and so forth. Instead, you get Ancient Power at 8, Psycho Cut 16, Safeguard 24, Amnesia 32, Aura Sphere at 40, Psychic at 48, Power Swap and Guard Swap at 56, Mist 64, Side Strike 72, Recover 80, Future Sight 88. Pretty awesome. Jirachi is going to learn Swift at 7, Helping Hand at 14, Life Dew 21, Zen Headbutt 28, Gravity 35, Psychic 42, Meteor Mash 49, Healing Wish 56, Rest 63, Future Sight 70, Double Edge 77, Cosmic Power 84, Last Resort 91, and Doom Desire 98. What's Doom Desire? I don't think I've ever heard that before. Oh, it's the signature move of Jirachi. Cool. Power 140, Accuracy 100, 5 PP. Oh, so it's kind of like Future Sight, but steel and cooler. Neat. Now there's one very, very important thing that I would like to point out here. All right? We do have confirmation that you are going to be able to transfer these Pokemon to Pokemon Home at a point in time in the future. In addition, you can make a second profile and play the game on that second profile. You then have to play the game to this point in time, which is honestly not that long. You could probably power through it in 1.5 hours, 2 hours tops to get these mythical Pokemon over and over again. So that's pretty awesome. Heads up, these are two of the only Pokemon that are shiny locked in the game. You cannot receive them shiny no matter how many times you soft reset for them. But the simple fact that, you know, you make a new profile, you play through 2 hours for two mythical Pokemon, that's not bad considering that, you know, Pokemon like this were previously held behind very, very exclusive events in some limited areas at some limited points in time or behind paywalls. Well, there you go, my dudes. That's how you're going to get two mythical Pokemon in Pokemon Brilliant Diamond and Shining Pearl. Did you find it helpful? Do me a favor, hit the thumbs up button down below. If you're enjoying the content, you may want to consider subscribing. Until next time, Austin John out.